Hello, chant. Fast food. Is it good? Is there a best one? Is there a worst one? Yes, yes, sometimes. I answered them backwards. So I said worst. Is there a worst one? Yes, there is. Is there a best one? Yes, there is. Is it good? Sometimes. I did it backwards. So we're going to do that today. I don't know. There's a lot of them. So actually, I might just jump into them because there's like 70 fucking restaurants here. I don't know how long it's going to take us to get through them. We got them up here. Here, I'll zoom in a little bit. 70, yeah, man. We're in it. We're starting. I'm just going to start in the order that they're here. The order that they're here, okay? And there's going to be some. If you disagree, that's fine. If you disagree, let me know, chat. Or let me know in YouTube in the comments later. Let me know if there's things you disagree with or things you agree with. I don't care because this is my opinion. It's not yours. This is my opinion. We can be a part of the conversation. That's how conversations work, right? This isn't really a conversation, right? There's a camera right there. I'm in front of the camera and I'm on the microphone, right? You can hear me, right? So it's more of a monologue to space. Twitch streaming is a monologue to space into the satellite. And then it's getting flopped around. A good debate can be healthy as long as people aren't being harmful to each other. I think that's really what I settled on as a person. You know what? You can have your thoughts. You can even use the wrong words. I might say something is sour. You might call it bitter. I might say that's the wrong word to use to describe Sour Patch Kids. But if you in your heart of heart, if that describes how that tastes to you and you're not harming anybody, you're not being hurtful to anybody, sweet. I'm glad that that's your reality because my reality is different than yours, but not when it comes to fast food lists. My reality is correct. Let's get back into it. I keep going on tangents, Daz. What do we got first? Arby's. We have the meats. Arby's is a tough one for me personally because here's the deal. This is how we're going to be ranking them. There's S tier, top tier. A, B, C, D, F. Pretty self-explanatory. Don't know why E is not in there, but it's not. Never been is something I've never eaten at, so I can't properly judge it. We're starting with Arby's. Back to Arby's. They have the meats. Arby's. We have the meats. When I was a kid, Arby's was special. Arby's was like the mecca. It was like, this is where we go for a night out. There wasn't one in the town I grew up in. We had to go to another town that was like 60 minutes away. In Nebraska, we say miles for time. That's how you measure time. You just say 60 miles, which means 60 minutes because it's 60 miles an hour on all the highways. Arby's was like, that's where you go. I'm gonna get that French dip sandwich with that au jus. Oh my God, it's so good. It's so good. They have a sauce, an Arby's sauce that is really, really good. And they have the curly fries. Curly fries. Curly fries are fucking fire. If you don't think curly fries are fire, get out. I don't want you here. I don't want you following my channel. If you've never had them, that's fine. But if you don't like curly fries, you can get out. Just get out of here. Unfollow. Ban me. Instead of me banning you, ban me from your thoughts. Because the Arby's sauce and those curly fries are dope as hell. But here's the deal. Arby's has kind of been slacking. And they're pretty expensive. So Arby's, I got 70 to get through. Arby's, I'm going to put you at a B. Okay, I used to love you, Arby's. You've changed a little bit. A lot of people make fun of you. So then there's like this thing that like if I go eat Arby's, I'm part of the being made fun of thing. So that's not your fault, Arby's. Specifically, this kind of society's fault for not giving you another chance. But Arby's, at this time, I have moved on. You used to be a very special place in my heart. But we all grow up. And now I kind of see we for what you are. And that's kind of overpriced fast food deli meat. You know, it's a B. It's good, it's there, but it's a B. Curly fries saved you, Arby's. All right, Checkers, never been, so can't talk about it. Jack in the Box, D. Jack in the Box is trash. The breakfast burritos are okay. They just have they got too much going on. They got burritos, they have like tacos, they have sandwiches, they have, you know, it's just too much, okay? And their mascot's creepy. And it's also, again, a little bit overpriced, I think. I haven't been there in a while. Jack in the Box, you're getting a D. Jimmy John's, all right. This is a real tricky one, okay? This is where things get political, chat, because Jimmy John's, the owner of Jimmy John's is a big game hunter, and not in like a sporty way. He just goes out and has, you know, people say, hey, there's the thing. Aim here, pull the trigger while I hold the gun. And he kills big animals that were just kind of hanging out. And that's shitty. And it's shitty, but the food's good. And in college, this was like all I ate. In college, Jimmy John's was like my go-to, you know, order it to the dorms. I don't have to leave. I don't have to drive my car around. Exactly. Well, we're rating the whole experience, right? Because fast food is the experience. Because we'll get into like Chick-fil-A later, but which I'm just, you know, just going to hard pass on it. I'll tell you that right now. But Jimmy John's, here's what I'll do. I'll give it a C, put it right in the middle. Decent sandwiches. And also sometimes the meat has a lot of fat in it. And that's not, I don't like that. It makes me like, you know, gag on the fat. Don't clip. Gag on the fat, baby. All right, Sonic. Sonic's pretty solid. The food isn't the best. The experience, I understand what they're trying to do, right? Where they're like, we're an old-timey, you know, we're have people coming out to your car to give you your food. You eat in your car. Isn't that fun? The experience usually isn't that great. The Route 44s are great. The dessert, the ice cream and stuff, fire. But everything else, food's always like a little soggy. It always feels a little bit soggy. So I'm going to put Sonic at the same area as Arby's. So we're going to put them in a B and we'll move on. Whataburger, I've had it once. I had Whataburger once. We had Whataburger. We had it for breakfast. It was fine. I don't really have enough to, you know, judge it. Honestly, I'm not really remembering the food that I had. So I'm going to put it at a C. I'm going to put it on the same level as Jimmy John's. White Castle, never been. I know. IHOP, IHOP stuff, man. I don't even know if I'd call this fast food. They're putting Applebee's in fast food. I guess that's fast casual, right? IHOP, I think I'm going to put all these, like the Applebee's and stuff, I'm going to put it at a D. And here's why. Because it's generic. The food's fine, but like the food at IHOP is going to taste the same as it does at Applebee's or Perkins or all these other restaurants that are similar. The issue is, and we'll get into this when we get to Applebee's, so maybe I'll wait on that. So we'll just wait on that. IHOP is a D. I think all those restaurants are going to be a D because it's fine. I understand. It's easy to take a big family. There's something for everybody there. Everybody gets their feel. We're putting it at D for now. Papa John's pizza. You know, the owner sucks a little bit. I guess there was some like racism with him, but he's out of there. Shaq is in. Butter sauce, the garlic butter sauce is dope. I think we're going to put it at an A. Yeah, Shaquille O'Neal. Yeah, the Papa John, John Papa Man. Shaquille O'Neal is in, and I stand Shaq. Panda Express is fine. I'm going to give it a C. I'll give it a C. We're going to kind of move along. There's a lot more of these. Popeye's Louisiana Kitchen. I'm going to give it a B. Little Caesars is another thing. It's kind of trash food, but it's like $5 for a large pizza. So in college, this saved my life. I would still destroy a Little Caesars pizza, but I'm going to put it at a C. Burger King. Burger King's food is fire. Burger King's burgers are better, I think, than a lot of fast food places. But Burger King's really fell off plus ratio. But I think I got to give it a D. So Wendy's. I love Wendy's burgers. There's so much juice in these burgers. But when you open up a Wendy's wrapper with a burger inside, you're not just getting the burger. You're also getting like a liter of grease. And sometimes that's what you need. A. It's an A in my book. Taco Bell. Okay, Taco Bell might be an S class, but it makes me poop bad. When I poop bad, I feel bad. But for the 30 minutes before I poop bad, I feel good. And then I feel bad. Taco Bell, I'm giving it an A. Subway. I actually like Subway. I'm going to put it at a B. So actually, I'm going to put Subway at an A because of the meatball marinara sub with pickles, banana peppers, if you want them, and olives. And then a little bit of mayonnaise. I'm not lying, but say a little bit and let them do like one little scoop. If you do too much, if you do like two little scoops, it's going to be too much. Five Guys. You're good, but you're expensive. An A. All right. Applebee's. I put Applebee's in the F class, and here's why. I feel like restaurants like Applebee's, they've taught consumers to treat service industry workers so shitty, and that like if you treat your server shitty, you'll get stuff. If you're awful to your server, then you get stuff. You'll come out on top, not the other way around. And I feel like that has kind of been lifted over to other things. We're starting to break the cycle. I'm going to restaurants where like not everybody's like, where's my food? Where's my food? I've been here for 2 minutes and nobody's given me a water. Like that shit, it needs to go. It needs to be purged from our society. And Applebee's, I feel like, has to be the sacrifice that is made. Sacrificial lamb, because it's at the top. Chili's is right there too. It's going to get its. You know what? I'll just do it right now. Chili's, it's a D, actually, because the food at Chili's is better. Applebee's does have that $1 Long Island iced tea or margarita or whatever the thing that comes up all the time. But that's another question. Do we, as a society, need that? Do we need a dollar Long Island iced tea available at Applebee's? I would posit, no, we don't. So I put Chili's, we're just going to kind of gloss over it. Chili's Baby Back Rib, one of the best songs to ever be put on a commercial. NSYNC fucking nailed it. Chili's, you're at a D. Chipotle? Yep, for me it is. For me, Chipotle is an S. I can't lie. I was about to lie. I was about to be like, no, you know, no, I love Chipotle, dude. Denny's. I'm going to put it here too. The food's a little bit better than Applebee's. I'm going to put it in an F. Actually, you know what? No. Denny's is a D. Denny's is a D. Domino's, C. CeCe's Pizza, D. Hardee's, C. KFC, I'm going to do this. I'm going to retroactively move Five Guys down. Okay. I'm sorry to do it. I'm sorry to retcon that way. But Buffalo Wild Wings. I haven't eaten here in like 8 years. I'm going to give Buffalo Wild Wings a B. The atmosphere is cool. It always feels like a thing. It feels like a thing where you can be somebody else while you're eating there, right? I watch football and stuff. I watch sports. I partake in them sometimes. But I'm not like the biggest, you know, jock. I'm not like, yeah. But if I'm at Buffalo Wild Wings, you can just become somebody else for like an hour and just be like nuts, scream with everybody. And everybody's like, yeah. Let's eat our wings. Yeah. And it's nice. Just kind of let that out a little bit and give it a taste. Because most of the time you give that a little taste and then you're like, man, that was so, I felt so dumb. Good thing I don't act like that in my real life. Thanks, Buffalo Wild Wings, for keeping it inside of your doors. Okay, we're on to Chick-fil-A. All right.